everyone. Today we are going to be doing Hippy Christmas. If you're a patchouli fan, you're gonna love this one. It's a blend of fresh patchouli, herbal sandalwood, hints of strawberry and raspberry, with a downy freshness of vanilla and peppermint leaf. And if you're not a huge patchouli fan, this is light enough where it's not gonna make you crazy. So it's not heavy patchouli, it's kind of a light to medium with a bunch of other really nice fresh stuff in it. So this is what we're gonna work with today. Now it discolors medium to light tan, and it has a very, very slight acceleration. As usual, when I have one that's an acceleration, I do a high olive oil soap. So try to use a higher level of olive oil and almost a full water amount for those that do accelerate some. Okay, so let's get moving. Today I'm gonna do a multicolored on this because it's hippie, you know, you gotta get crazy. Now because it's accelerates, I'm going to separate at emulsification stage, and I'm going to color before I add my fragrance. So I'm going to do four colors today. I'm dripping. Go that way. There we go. All right. So here we go. Now, so we're gonna go ahead and add yellow to the main batch because I want it sort of bright, but I know it's going to discolor some, so I'm doing kind of a bright yellow. Also going to do a bright green. And I'm going to do blue. Get a light red, pinkish red. Let's see what I got left. There we go. And now, because I know this fragrance is going to discolor, or not discolor, but accelerate, sorry, I went blank there. I'm gonna hand stir it in instead of stick blending it in. That way it doesn't move too quickly on me. So into our yellow, our red, our blue, and our green. those aside. Grab my mold. And there we go. I'm gonna do some yellow on the bottom. Now see, because I did that the way I did it, by only hand mixing that in and only bringing it to emulsification, it's not thickening up too fast on me for me to have some fun. So I'm doing some green. I'm gonna do some red. And I'm keeping just a smidge out at the bottom. I'm gonna do another little bit of yellow. And blue. A little bit more green. Now I'm just doing this line straight down the middle, and I'm letting them create their own swirl. Drizzle just a little bit on top. Make it look like paint splatter. I'm going to let this set up just a little bit so I don't overflow my mold. And we'll be back to do the top. Be right back. So, you know what? This did not accelerate at all for me. It's still relatively loose. And when I turned off the camera, I spent the next 15 minutes doing other orders. So, you know, look how thin that still is. So, I guess it's really going to depend on your recipe with this one, ladies. So, worked great for me. All right, I'm going to finish it off by topping with some more of that bright, bright yellow. Because I want to get like a base of that. Smooth that a bit. And now I've got... If you want an herb that stays relatively green and doesn't go black on your soap, parsley. Parsley, folks. So this has got peppermint and stuff in it, so it'd be a beautiful winter soap. So I'm gonna use parsley to represent the spearmint. So I'm gonna do a line right down the middle. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Pretty. Oh, let's bring a little over to the side. What the heck? With that herbally feel to it. Oh, it smells good. Mmm. And I'm not a patchouli girl. I know. Sacrilegious. I know. It's true, though. I'm not a big patchouli fan. And this is one of those patchouli scents I can actually dig on. You know, it's got enough of the fresh, fruity, pepperminty to not overwhelm me with patchouli. And there we go. All right, let me clean that. And then I've got some cranberry seeds. And, you know, use this at your discretion. You can use as much or as little as you like. This is not you have to do it this way show. And that gives us our Christmassy look. Because remember, it's also got raspberry and strawberry in it. So it brings a touch of that to it as well. So it gives it a Christmassy look, represents the earthy patchouli and the beautiful fruits that are in there. You know, my yellow's got my beautiful like vanilla kind of flavoring. There we go. Now, because I want it to somewhat stick, I'm going to use back of a spoon just to lightly tamp some of that in, because some of it's just kind of floating on the top. But don't go crazy or you screw it all up. I'm good at that. I get too enthusiastic and I just go, ah! But that's okay, because handmade soap, it doesn't matter. It's still a beautiful thing, right? There we go. Messy, messy. Okay. And I'll come by with the swoop. Okay, are you ready to see our psychedelic crazy hippie colors? Check that out. Yeah, it's gonna be amazingly crazy. Okay. Do do do. Ta-da! Check it out. Very cool. I'm very happy with that. Look at that. That is awesome. Very, very cool. Hippy Christmas, baby. Oh, you know what? The peppermint really comes through when it's soaked. Oh, that's nice. I am loving these. Fantastic. All right, guys. So my final evaluation, this did not accelerate on me at all. I mean, at all. You guys saw how much time I had to play with it. Heck, I even let it set up in the mold for like 15 minutes to be able to do the top. So, I say go for it. I think this would be great for a column pour or any of those intricate pours. Yeah, fantabuloso. Hippie Christmas. Way to go.